Well, everybody, I am back. It's Jeff again, another episode of Minecraft from the Minecraft server. And I last left you off up on that tower because it was night. I made a little area right here where I'm smelting some iron. I've got some. I put a bunch of stuff up in my chest so I don't have nearly as much anymore so I can go exploring. And this way, I believe, is taking me to the more negative location in both directions. It is. So it's nighttime, so we're going to cruise. And what did I say? I'm in an ocean biome. So, unfortunately, with the ocean biomes, they could be huge, they could be small. So I might be going this way an awful long ways. I did write down those coordinates to where that stuff's at because I actually probably should have made another portal there. It's okay. I left. Did I bring it? I think I brought my. Yeah, I brought my obsidian with me. I should have left 10 pieces back there, but I did not. Oops, I slowed down apparently. I did not. Oh yeah, I forgot boats move faster in this update. I'm very curious because I've logged in twice just to kind of check things out real quick since I've last recorded, and both times my game updated. So obviously with every update there's been bugs and there's had to be, you know, subsequent updates right afterwards. I'm really curious on what, like, glitches and exploits I missed out on that they had to patch again. Oh, this looks good. Let's go over here. I'm just kind of going out to the more negative direction where I think is relatively new so I can see how this boat exit works. Boat exit worked pretty well. Because that was supposedly one of the things that was fixed in this update. Whee! Ice. Ice is great. Oh, you know what? Oh, no, I don't have silk touch. Never mind. I was going to say I can pick up some ice, but I cannot. I want to venture out and find. Actually, I probably should have stayed in that desert, huh? Oh, well. I'm going more negative. I can always go back to that desert. I'm more just running around and trying to find new terrain and new items and stuff that came out in the 1.3 update. Ow. I have also just now re-networked my house. The roommate that currently had the network set up and it was his router and all that stuff when I moved in, he is the one that is he's moving out and we're getting a new roommate, so we had to replace the router, and it was fine because I have plenty of extra routers, but it gave me the opportunity, since he was disconnecting his stuff, to move the cable box up into, or the internet box up into my room, and set up a wireless network downstairs instead of the other way around, where my roommate likes to play on his Xbox Live and things like that. So he had to have he has an old Xbox and not a wireless connection, so he had a hardline connection in, and everybody else is running wireless in the house, including me and my desktop setup. I had a router set up to work as an access point to connect the wireless network, so I can get all my. I have two desktops running up here. I have my Xbox running for my streaming and all that stuff, but it's a lot of things that require hardline connections and not wireless connections. But I figured out a long time ago how to set up my access point using DDWRT software or firmware, putting it on an old Linksys router, and it works great. It just, unfortunately, it cuts your connection speed, which normally isn't a problem. It's usually fine, but when I'm running things like, if I'm trying to play Minecraft at the same time that he's playing like Call of Duty or something, as well as either downloading or transferring media or even watching streaming media over to my Xbox, it's taken up so much of the bandwidth because of the wireless connection that I'm using that it makes my game jumpy, and it makes it so my connection speeds aren't there. Downloading videos to watch on YouTube kind of sometimes takes forever. I have to kind of let them buffer for a while and load before I can watch them. And hopefully the new setup that I have, since I'm directly hard. Ooh, a village. I think that's a village. Oh, that's not a village. Wait, what the hell is that? Why does it look like a village? Oh, I thought that this was like the front of a steeple, and apparently it's not. But this is the first time I'm actually testing, so we'll see if I drop my connection or if I get really laggy or anything like that, and then as I continue to watch YouTube videos or even upload a video, it'll be a good way to test what's going to happen. And I'm going to mute my mic. Woo, sorry about that, guys. I just had a huge sneeze coming on that luckily I was able to mute the mic for, so You guys do not have to deal with the huge sneeze. Whoa. That was a little laggy, but that could be just the game loading itself. It's kind of running around. Whoa! I don't need to collect more iron. I don't necessarily... Wait, what kind of biome am I in? An ice plains. An ice plains? There's lava in the ice plains. Oops. Ah! I don't want to go down here. I wanted to go back out that door. Look at these skeletons! They're just chilling. Oh, how did I miss him? That was ridiculous. There's three of them down here. There's four of them down here. There we go. I'm just gonna run down here real quick because I'm curious if there's... Nope, just natural spawns. This thing goes like straight on down. That's relatively entertaining. Oh, an abandoned mine shaft. Hi, creeper. Oh, I'm surprised you still blew up. God damn, that stupid gravel. Keep thinking, I thought it was cobble. I thought I came across a dungeon. But I did not. I'm going to steal some of this. Well, zombie. That was mean. Steal some of this, well, that's not going to work at all. That's not going to work at all either. I really need this rail. And I'm making you guys watch me collect all this. What was that? Oh, that water glistened in a funny way. I thought it was, a diamond. This will work. So we're going to see how this internet connection works out, and hope that all is good. Oh, a chest. I love chests down here. Those contain cool stuff. An iron pick, that's kind of cool. I actually don't have any need for pumpkin seeds or melon seeds, so they can come out of my inventory. I normally just use water on these things, but the problem is the water, it's going to go toward the closest path down, and I happen to be, like, this one I can use water on. So I can go like this, and all the rails pop up for me. But those other ones at the edge, you'll only get, like, one piece because it's going to go down the path. It's very close. So other than that, I'm trying to think what's going on. I actually start a new class. Well, okay, I'm supposed to be starting my preceptorship for my nursing informatics degree. And this is dumb. This is a fun story. Not really a story. But I'm starting my preceptorship for nursing informatics, and I was able to contact a person, a nursing informaticist I worked with for a while when I was doing my... For those of you who don't know, I was doing the electronic health record switchover for the past year. The last year I worked in the emergency department, I was the emergency department liaison for my hospital on that, based on my... They put me in there based on the fact that I have a computer engineering and an IT degree, thinking it'd be a good fit. Which it is a good fit, but unfortunately what they needed me for has nothing to do with programming. It's more nursing. They wanted the nursing perspective on how things work. They didn't want people actually with any don't blow up my rail track. So creepers have gotten a little bit of a buff. I think it might be impossible to go get that stuff back. It very well has the illusion of impossibility because I was down in a random mine shaft, but that illusion of possibility makes me... Why are my cats in here? Get off the bed! Come on. Get off my bed. You're better than that. Trained you right. That was unexpected. So basically, I did see somebody, I can't remember actually if it was Etho or if it was Kurt J. Mack. I don't remember who did it. They did the whole creeper testing thing and show that creepers had been increased to where they will blow you up if you get hit directly in the face, like I did. I don't know why you're all out of your cages, like I just did. Oh my god, I got those that good pick and everything's over there. Oh, I just kind of screwed up. That's okay. How do I restart? I think I had diamonds up in this chest. I'm gonna make some supplies, make my way back out to where I started the episode out at, and from there, we're going to venture together and see what the possibility is of actually re- Oh, I have a diamond. That's just great. See what the possibility is of actually reclaiming any of that gravel. Fuck you. Of reclaiming any of that stuff. So, I will see you guys in a little bit. Well, guys, I see my pillar, and I have found out that boats no longer break. That's pretty cool. I mean, they might break. I don't know if I run into anything, but if you click on them multiple times, they don't just break up into sticks and logs. Instead, they actually form a boat. So I went this way from here until I caught the shoreline. So we're gonna see if not only I can run, find what the hole I went down, but also make my way all the way down to where I died, and doing so without torches, because I don't have any torches. I forgot to make them, which is probably a pretty dumb move, but you know, if I can get back into that cave, it shouldn't really matter because I should be able to follow my lit path back to where I was. But let's see, how did I do this? Did I stop and get out right here? I remember I came up to the ice and I went jumping over the hills to the right. There's a bunch of cows. They look familiar. Actually, you know what? I should be able to find out 'cause, oh, there's my boat. I was gonna say, I forgot I left my boat there. And there's my boat because I went up this way. I did not leave any lights because it was in the middle. Let's see what happens when I actually run this into the. Oh, that time it actually does break when you run into something, it looks like. Now I'm unfortunately on like a time crunch because I might have loaded that chunk. Yeah, I came down here. I remember falling actually exactly right there and taking fall damage. It wasn't too far into this. I came across a set of pumpkins. And then a second set of pumpkins it was kind of close to. I do recall that. I wasn't paying that much attention because I wasn't expecting the death. Did I run across the ice for a while? I don't remember. I couldn't have gone too far if I ran across the ice for a while because. Because it ends. That was not the cave that I went into. That was not the cave that I went into. That was also not the cave that I went into. Good God. Things are everywhere. Does anything look familiar? Where are pumpkins? Nothing looks familiar. Nothing looks familiar at all. I might need to stop and go back and rewatch that video. Jump up here real quick. Because the back side of the island. Oh, pumpkins. I saw these pumpkins. I saw these pumpkins. It should be like a little area in the ground. Where there was, like, water. Because it was next to the water. Oh no! It was not that. It was not this. Shoot! I'm losing time, guys. I'm losing too much time. I'll be back. Okay. Apparently, I'm still relatively far away from where I was at, according to the video. I ran it this way. A long ways! Now, I guess the fact that I wasn't really paying attention to what I was doing because I was just exploring made me think that I was a lot closer. But I came running way up over here. I jumped over some mountains. I jumped over some ice for a while. That actually might have been before this. But and then I saw that thing that I thought was the village off in the distance somewhere this way. I'm pretty sure this is still the right direction. So now I'm confused again because this does not look familiar from the video that I watched. And I did just watch a video of myself. That is not a question. I listen to me just retell the same stories. But I'm hoping that that chunk is not yet loaded because I'm still so far. Whoa! I thought I was gonna take a long fall off of there, but it wasn't that bad. So somewhere way up over here, though, but this mountain terrain does not look familiar at all. It would be okay if I was going the wrong direction, because then things would not still be loaded if I was going like the complete opposite direction of where I'm supposed to be going. Because none of this stuff is looking familiar at all. Oh, wait. There's pumpkins. It's right around pumpkins on the ground. Which means I need to hurry now if this is it. Oh, this is it. This is where I went down. Wait, I went down right here. Okay. Where is this? 31. Okay, I got it in the coordinate system. And I remember I built my way through here. Oh, shit. I did make armor. That was smart. When I did this. I went down for a long ways, following these torches. I must have gone down here, because here's the mine shaft. Oh, Etho was on it. I didn't even notice. I jumped down here. I obviously went this way. Here's that chest. Come on, baby. I went over here. I went up this way. There's some cobble. Okay, so there's still cobble here that I had broken, which is a good sign. That was not one of my torches. I don't recall passing any of this stuff. Those are not my torches anymore. I feel like I'm cheating by rewatching my video, but at the same time, I really need that stuff back. Those are not. Those are naturally spawned torches. That one is not. I can get my bearings off of here and find out exactly where I went if I disconnect. Hold on. Sorry about that. Apparently I was recording a bunch right there, but I am going the right direction. I'm like right up here to the left. Like I said, I feel like it's kind of cheating, but at the same time I needed it. Because I need this stuff back. It wasn't even my pick. Wasn't it over here? There it is! That's why I didn't notice it, because it was dark. Oh my god. Get out. Get out. Get out. I don't... Oh my god. Where's my important stuff? Screw you arrows. Screw you sticks. Pick, pick, pick. Get out of here, apple. There's the efficiency pick. Do I have the other one? Oh, I do have them both. Woo! Let me real quick... Someone's gonna come behind me and kill me is what's gonna happen in a minute here. I'm just putting a bunch of stuff away just so I can turn around and grab everything else and then get organized. Whew, oh, there's a chest right there too, but where's my torches? I need to get torches on this wall, on this floor. Whew! I did not think that was possible. Where am I? Okay, there we go. Wow. So there's my old armor. How's my new... My new armor's fine. I don't even need to update it at all. I don't need all this stuff. I do... Okay, let me organize. Okay, got myself organized again. Whew. Got these picks. That was this fortune was the important one, just because I have not had luck getting a fortune pick yet. I really don't need this iron. I don't know why I started grabbing it, but now that I have started grabbing it, I've got to kind of finish out that pocket at least. But what I was saying was the fact that my nursing informatics internship, or my preceptorship, is all I have left in my nursing informatics degree. I've been putting it off for a long time. Oh, wait, there's a chest back there I wanted to go get. I've been putting it off for a long time, and then I really started trying to, like, organize and get things going with it. So, oh, there's two chests right here. Probably didn't need to make any chests, because I had two of them right here I could have had. Nice. My nursing informatics internship is... I need to get it set up so I can get finished with my degree is all I'm waiting on. And I was able to contact the person I used to work with when I was doing the whole electronic medical record switchover things. And she said she'd graciously take me on to be, to get precepted and finished, because her hospital already has an agreement with the university that I'm going to, and it's going to, like, alleviate a lot of that process and all this stuff. And we've already worked together, so... She knows me, she knows my skills, she's all good with taking me on. So I'm like, great. So I'm sending in all this paperwork, and they contacted me and said, well, you're going to be working for NRH, which is the National Rehab Hospital, and it is a sister hospital to the hospital that I work for. It's actually on the same campus ground. Like, I wouldn't even have to go anywhere. I'd have to, the entrance, holy fuck, the entrance to, you know what? The last portal I made in the station starting room. So, you know what? I'm going to continue on doing that. Look at my cords so that they're there in the video. We're going to make a portal right here. And it's going to be a nice little start. Oh, come on. Can't believe I placed you in the wrong spot. But they contacted me back and said that was dumb. Come on. Said I have to go through orientation at NRH. I said, okay, I understand that. That's not a big deal. They also contacted me back, and somebody else did, and said, oh, I heard you're, you know, gonna be starting with, you know, doing this project at our hospital for your preceptorship. So this is the information I need from you. We need to get, you know, a complete health physical. So where is this going to take me to now? Well, they look the exact same, but they're different. Good thing I put those coordinates in, because I obviously can't get back there now. But I guess this is a good time to go and drop some of this stuff off of my base. I don't even have everything that I wanted, because I got a lot of good stuff in that other chest. But I can go back to my original base and drop a lot of stuff off, I guess, which is a plus. But they wanted me to get them my health records, my immunization records. I need to have a physical within the past year. I need to have a background check, and I need to have a drug test. I'm like, okay, for one, I'm not doing patient care. I'm working in nursing informaticism. Nursing informatics. I'm going to be working behind a computer. Why do my immunizations have to be up to date, for one, with this? For another thing, I work. I'm a nurse. I have all this stuff on file. I work at the corporation that owns both these hospitals. I work at one already. And I told her, and I said, I already work at, you know, Washington Hospital Center. Can you just get my records all from them? So, I mean, I work at the same corporation. Do I need to really do all this stuff? And she said, well, yes, you still need to do all that stuff. And I said, okay, my hospital does not require that I get a drug test done every year. I don't know how often they require it. I just had my physical done, so that's easy. I can get over there. And I said, I didn't get a drug test done this year because my hospital doesn't require it. I was like, do you know where I can go get a drug test done then? Because I'm not going to pay to have a drug test done or a background check done when it's stuff that's standard as part of to get my nursing licensure and all that stuff anyways. And she's like, she literally responded with, this isn't the same person I'm working with. This is like one of their HR people that work at the, ooh, they're in love. Aww. I'm watching you. Okay, I'll turn around. What? Is this a, what? What? Are they all in love? Dude, Minecraft, you're into some kinky shit. I'm, strangely aroused. They must have worn condoms too, because there's no children. I'm gonna leave them alone and go find a different house, I think, because that's... I will go in the sanctity of the church. Yes. Whew. But anyways, she basically wrote back and straight up said, I don't know where you can get a drug test done, you just need to get it done. And I'm like, really? That's the way it works? The fact that I work at your hospital system already doesn't matter. And you're not even going to give me advice on where to get this stuff done. Just tell me I need to have it. Like, that's kind of an interesting way to go about things. And granted, in a way, they are helping me out because I'm not paying them to do this. But they're also not paying me to do this. They're basically getting free labor out of people. And I'm going to end up working on the same project that they used to pay me for to do. I'm going to be working on that exact same project as part of this preceptorship now for free just so I can finish this. And they're going to make me jump through hoops to work on something I've already done for them now for free. So it's just kind of really annoying. So I called my hospital and I'm just trying to kind of leverage a drug test. I just called them up to try to schedule a drug test. They're supposed to call me back. Because you can't just call and talk to somebody, of course. They have to call you back through their answering service. It's kind of weird, but my occupational health area, I was just like, I need to schedule a drug test. I'm to go with my physical. I just had my physical done recently, and now I'm working on a joint program with NRH, and they require a drug test to be done, so I need to schedule one of those. And I'm not worried about the drug test. I don't do drugs or anything. I just need to get it done. I'm just not planning on finding a place to go pay for it to get it done. And it's just really annoying. It's dumb, the loopholes you have to jump through. And then let alone with Walden. Walden is the place that I'm doing this through. And Walden University is just a joke. I'm going to put it out there for everybody. I go there. I'm going to get a degree from there. I don't give a shit. It's a fucking joke. I am learning nothing. If I ever get into a management position and see somebody like with a degree from Walden University, I'm not going to think bad on them because I did the same thing. But if they try to tout themselves as having this, like, oh, I'm like such a smart person. I've got my master's degree with a 4.0 from Walden University. You know, I worked really hard at it. Fuck no, you didn't. Like, that shit is like, it's a joke. The only reason that I feel that I'm going to be a fine nursing informaticist is because I have a computer engineering and IT degree. It has nothing to do with what I've learned at Walden, because what I've learned at Walden is nothing. Absolutely nothing. We had these group projects. The only class that you potentially could have learned anything and that has anything to do with not like the stupid nursing theories that we've already learned. I'm not saying that nursing theories are stupid. I'm saying that the master's program is based around relearning stuff you already learned in your undergraduate degree. So it's just redoing the same assignment. So it was really dumb, like writing papers on Florence Nightingale and her like theories of, you know, nursing and patient care and blah, blah, blah. Like, it's just dumb. They're just rehashing stuff that's already been done for everybody in order to earn a bachelor's degree. But the only class I could have potentially learned anything in is one of them was on like database design. And the ironic thing is they split everybody up into, it was a group project, so there was like six groups of four or five people apiece, and in my group project, I designed the database because they didn't teach you how to do it, you had to learn it from a book. That stuff's hard to learn from a book for people who are computer savvy. Databases are kind of weird, but for those people who are not computer savvy and are just nurses who don't know much about computers, which is a lot of the people that go to like these degrees, they do them because they want to move on to like the normal 8-to-5 type business side and have a cubicle and things like that. Some people really want to do that, and their goal is to go there, and they think nursing informaticist is good because computers are up and coming. That it's going to be like part of the future of the healthcare system, which it truly is. But they go into these degrees not knowing much about computers, not being very computer literate, which is fine. That's how they learn. They go to school for it. The problem is you can't learn this stuff from a book if you don't know much about this stuff. So I ended up designing our entire database and doing everything. And everybody was so confused but so grateful that I was doing it because they didn't understand it. They didn't know what they were supposed to do. And then we had to go evaluate the other group projects. Not a single one of the other groups actually designed a database. They took information and basically said, this is the information we would have in our database, and they put it in like an Excel file. So it was just tables that they would have had in the database, but they didn't learn how to do database design, which was the point of the class, because they didn't know how to do it. And they still got like 4 points in the class because the professor was impressed with their ideas for what's going to be in the database. But the point was to learn how to create a database. Like, the whole system, I don't know how they're accredited. I'm sitting here bashing the school I'm about to get a master's degree from that's going to launch my career forward. But everything I know about nursing informatics is stuff that I learned in my IT degree and my computer engineering degree. It has nothing to do with what I'm learning in this. And I know I'm ranting a lot right now, but it's just, it really makes me mad that this school is raking in so much money. And the reason they're doing so is because it's easy, it's online, and they don't deny anybody. Because how much does it cost them if a student starts and fails? Nothing, because they got like 60 people in this class taught by this one adjunct instructor who doesn't read papers and just kind of gives like anywhere between like an 80 and 100% based on how they feel. Like, only one class that I have that the professor actually gave comments and feedback on the paper, and I was actually happy to get comments and feedback because I felt that the professor cared and was actually trying to make sure that we learned stuff and wrote proper papers. But instead, all the other ones, there would be like no comments on the paper, and it'd be like 92%, and then they'd have the like the markdown on everything that you're supposed to have in the paper, and they'd mark me down for something saying this wasn't in there, and I'd write back and say, no, it was clearly in there, there's a whole section in my paper that's labeled exactly that, that talks about exactly that. And then they'd respond back with, oh, sorry, I didn't see that, and give me the points back. They didn't, I don't even know. Sorry, that was a fun little rant, but anybody who ever touts the fact that they got a degree from Walden University and thinks it's like a big deal, you know, shut up, because it's ridiculous. I have a 4 point in my master's degree program right now, and I have put in so little effort. It was time-consuming at times because some of the papers I had to write were very long and took a lot of research, quote-unquote research, just finding the right articles to quote stuff from, not really researching anything or learning anything new. So time-consuming existed, but actual learning and actual difficulty level, minimal, very, very minimal. So, that being said, guys, this is a great episode. I'll see you guys next time.